Now, Pep Guardiola will return to the dugout for Manchester City's trip to West Ham tomorrow. He missed the two games prior to the international break because of emergency back surgery. Let's go live to Alan Owen, who was speaking to the City boss this lunchtime. Let's make a bit of space for him, shall we? Here is Alan, live here on Total Football. Now, Pep discussed in more detail Kyle Walker's decision to sign a new deal. I'd imagine he must be pretty chuffed to keep hold of the England international who not so long ago, like Harry Kane, was linked with a move to Bayern Munich, Alan.
Yeah, he was absolutely delighted, was Pep Guardiola. I mean, Kyle Walker played really well in the internationals and he started the season so well for Manchester City. And we should remember that it wasn't too long ago when Pep Guardiola left him out of the side, saying he couldn't play a specific positional role for the football club. He also didn't start the Champions League final, but he's back this season seemingly better than ever. He's been captaining the side too. All in all, Pep Guardiola stated that Kyle Walker has displayed a fantastic attitude.
I'm with Kyle 7 years ago, 7 years since together. We know each other without a doubt. And Kyle, when didn't play sometimes is for tactical reason, never because it was a bad behavior or whatever, but of course he's an important figure, want to play all the time. That's why he was thinking to leave, but he talked a lot with his mates, with the club, and then he decided. So whatever playing or playing, Kyle since day one had been really, really important player for us. Our success belongs to him, yes or yes, for the amount of games. I was so really, really sad, don't let him play in the final Champions League, because for the way they play, I believe in that build-up for right for Manu, maybe will help us, you know, a little bit. And but look how he responds since then, from every pre-season games and seasons, was committed with the team. And he made me realize how important he is and how he behaved on the pitch, and especially off. And I spoke with the mates, with a lot of players, and most of them tell me, Kyle can leave. So it's really important in the locker room. And I think making a step forward, and when he does, it's having specific qualities you cannot find all around the world. So when he has to control the best wingers in the planet, so who can do better than him?
Did you see the video released by the club?
Yeah, it was really nice. Yeah. Even with that, our club is getting better, even these social departments. It was really, really good. The guy who has the idea, chapeau, heads off. So it was really good.
Good to see him back, isn't it, after back surgery. And amongst the other talking points, Alan, Gareth Southgate saying that Phil Foden can't play in the middle. So obviously Phil Foden involved in the games over the international break. What did Pep Guardiola have to say about that?
Yeah, plenty of Manchester City players in the spotlight, I suppose, during the international break, and none more so than Phil Foden following those Gareth Southgate comments. But let's remember that Pep Guardiola is a big, long-time admirer of his player, Phil Foden, and he certainly believes that he can play anywhere on the pitch.
I have an incredible relation with Gareth, any comment of me. So looks like I'm a disagree with him and I completely agree with him. So in the fact that when you play outside on the middle, it's completely different role, but he knows, I know, that Phil can play in all positions up front, in the middle and outside, right, left, in the pockets. But as Gary has said, in the pockets have another responsibility, especially without the ball. Sometimes you have to be so smart to read what happened every moment. But the important is Phil can play in the five position up front without a problem, and this is a big advantage for him.
Yeah, just an update as well on the fitness of a number of Manchester City players. John Stones and Jack Grealish, who both missed the internationals, will be unavailable for this weekend. Pep doesn't know at this stage how long they will be missing, but he's hopeful that they may be back for the Champions League game against Red Star Belgrade here on Tuesday. Also, Mateo Kovacic, who didn't figure for Croatia during the internationals, he will miss tomorrow at West Ham with a muscular problem. Again, we don't know how long that will keep him out for. As far as Pep himself is concerned, he was looking well. He said he'll get fitter by the week, and hopefully his team can continue to do well. They didn't seem to miss him, did they? And he's back to take charge at West Ham tomorrow. He's unbeaten in all 14 of his Premier League meetings against West Ham, but you suspect, given David Moyes' side's start to the season, that they'll certainly give Manchester City a bit of a run for the money. So it's West Ham against Manchester City tomorrow.
Thank you very much indeed, Alan.